Welcome one and all to Country Preaching. Don Drake here, and it's good to have you in the listening audience. Invite you to stay around the next few minutes. Let us borrow a little bit of your time, ride a few miles down the road with you, visit with you in your home, your place of business, leave you with a few thoughts, a song, and a message from God's Word. Christians never meet for the last time. So true, Christians never meet for the last time. No one is so old that he cannot live another year, nor so young that he cannot die today. Living is death, dying is life. On this side of the grave, we are exiles. On that side, citizens. On this side, we're orphans. On that side, children. On this side, we're captives. On that side, we're free. On this side, we're disguised and unknown. On that side, disclosed and proclaimed as sons of God. Here's a thought for today. A man is a fool who thinks because he does not believe in hell, his opinion shuts the door and puts the fire out. Here's a song. We'll be back with a message from God. I want to speak to you a few minutes today from John chapter 3, beginning with verse 19. And this is the condemnation, that light has come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest that are wrought in God. I mentioned there are 2 degrees of darkness. One is absolute darkness, where there's never been any light, such as in heathen countries. The other kind of darkness is that which follows rejected light. Notice the Bible says, for everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. And this is the condemnation, that light has come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds are evil. That's the reason why it's so hard to get folks to come to church, come to revivals. They don't want to be around God's people, because God's people that's walking with him turns the light on, and they feel uncomfortable, out of place, and their sins condemn them. Now, God never drafts anybody. You'll never get a summons from God to report for duty. You only get an invitation, and my friend, you can treat it as you please. The Lord will invite you, and the Spirit of God does invite, but you'll have to do with it what you will. It's only in the will of God that we find freedom. Adam and Eve wanted to be free, but they became bound. As soon as we leave the will of God, we must punch the clock out of freedom into slavery. And the 7th chapter of Romans is one long groan of what it is not to be free. Paul says, describes it, and it's like a man who wants to do good and he can't. He doesn't want to do evil, but he's always doing evil. And folks will wonder, why do I do what I do? Because you are what you are, a sinner with a sinner's nature, and you can't help yourself. You take to sin as a duck takes to water. A man wants to do good and he can't. He doesn't want to do evil, but he does. Satan tells folks, if you become a Christian, you can't be free. Now, what he's really saying is, if you become a Christian, you can't curse anymore, you can't swear, you can't run around, you can't raise the devil anymore. What the devil, what he fails to tell you is that you don't want to do those things anymore. What he really means is, we don't wear his handcuffs, and we don't have his collar around our neck. I mean, in Christ, we're free. We can do what we want to do, but God regulates the want to. I mean, our want to has been fixed. Amen. Those who are regulated by sin are still in darkness. They want to hide and remain in darkness and do evil deeds. Now, Christ shines the light. The Lord will be the one that will judge man. Paul was God's man, but I wouldn't want Paul to be my judge. Moses was God's man, but I wouldn't want Moses to be my judge. Elijah, the old prophet of fire, was God's man, but I don't want him to be my judge. I don't want to be judged by an archangel who never shed a tear, nor by a serpent who've never felt a pain, or a cherubim who had never known grief, human grief, or disappointments. I wouldn't want to be judged by angels who've never gone through the trials and never been through what we've been through. Only Jesus qualifies, because he became one of us. There was never a tear he didn't shed. There was never a disappointment he didn't feel. There was never a grief he didn't suffer. There was never a temptation he did not experience. There was never a critical situation with which he did not wrestle. We cannot afford to face him as our judge until we face him as our Savior. He knows too much about us. He's been through it all. He accepts no excuses. Thank God for the privilege of sending our sins on to judgment and having them taken care of in advance. That's the good news. Amen. We don't have to face the judgment condemned and in sin. We can come to the Lord Jesus now and have our sins taken care of and sent on ahead of us and taken care of. Jesus did not cover our sins with his life, but with his death. That way the devil cannot find them. They're under the blood. And the songwriter says, they're underneath the blood of the cross of Calvary, as far removed as darkness is from dawn. In the sea of God's forgetfulness, that's good enough for me. Praise God, my sins are gone. Amen, my friend. The devil can't find the sins now. They're underneath the blood, thank God. Will you give heed to the inner voice? I mean, my friend, the light's shining down your way today. What are you going to do? You're going to hide from that light? You're going to reject that light? You're going to get lost from it and try to get away from the light? The Lord Jesus, the Holy Spirit, is sending the light, turning the light on in your heart just now. Some cold heart says, well, if only we could hear great preachers today like Moody and Billy Sunday. If we had some of those old-time preachers, I'd get saved. No, my friend, the Holy Spirit, he cannot do more than turn on the light. And I'm telling you, I believe with all of my heart the Holy Spirit is turning on that light. You hear a gospel song, the light comes on. You hear a gospel message, the light comes on. My friend, it's up to you. What are you going to do with that light? The Lord Jesus is shining the light down your pathway this morning. What are you going to do? Are you going to reject that light? Are you going to try to hide from it? Or will you come to the light and say, Lord, forgive me. I want my sins forgiven. Don Drake here, God's way is best.